The Catholic Channel SiriusXM 129 presents Sounds from the Spires with Dr. Jennifer Pascual, Music Director of St. Patrick's Cathedral.
Welcome to Sounds from the Spires. This is Dr. Jennifer Pascual, and you're listening to the Catholic Channel on SiriusXM 129. And today we have a very special treat. Dr. Rosa Antonelli has been with us before, and she's played with us live in the studios at the SXM studios in New York. But today, because we still are in a pandemic, we are having a kind of almost like a home concert. Rosa is going to be playing from her home to my home, and eventually to your homes or your cars or wherever you listen to the Catholic Channel on SiriusXM. And so we're very blessed to have her. She has a CD called Bridges that she had produced. What is it now, Rosa? 2 years ago? Almost now?
CD Bridges came out in the end of August 2019.
2019. It seems so much longer than that.
Yes.
Okay. So the last time I interviewed you was by telephone then. Yes. And it's a beautiful CD, Bridges, from Chopin to Piazzolla. And Rosa Antonelli is our guest today. And she's going to perform for us from her home to my home and to all of your homes. And Dr. Rosa is a specialist in Latin American and Spanish music. She's a great pianist who's performed all over the world. And Rosa, she's been on our show, I think, 2 or 3 times now. And how have you been before you start playing for us? Because I know you have a lot of music you want to play, and you're blessing us with your talent. How have you been during this pandemic time, Dr. Rosa? Have you been able to get out much? I assume that maybe performances have been canceled. How has this been for you?
Oh, it has been very hard. I mean, of course, I couldn't go out. I was trying to, all my concerts were canceled, like everybody else, no?
Yes.
And then it was when all of this about performing from home became something now kind of normal, no? And at least I feel now, with this possibility, I feel a little bit better as an artist, because I think I can bring my music and my, in some ways, my comfort, because the music gives me so much peace. And I feel like in this way, we can do the same to other people home, no?
Yes.
And that's why we are all learning this new way, no? And this is what I was doing. I was having a lot of newspapers, interviews, and trying to do the same from home.
Yes, yes. And Dr. Rosa is going to do a live performance next week on Thursday, June 25th at 7:30. And so she's going to have a remote watch party on YouTube. So check that out. She's going to play a full program. But today we're going to get a little taste of that. She's going to play some pieces for us. From her Bridges CD, and again, Dr. Rosa Antonelli is a specialist in Latin American and Spanish repertoire, and is a fantastic pianist and an amazing person. So tell us maybe just a little bit about the first piece you're going to play, Danza del Trigo.
Yes, this piece is very special because this piece is a transcription from the ballet Estancia, and then this first piece describes the whole day in a ranch, no? Mm-hmm. And then particularly this Dance of the Wheat describes the workers in the morning planting and cultivating the wheat, no? And how all the lights come through all the leaves, no? It's something very especially romantic and very moving, no? It's a very romantic piece. Yes, and that's why I decided not to follow the order of the CD, which is from Chopin to Piazzolla. I like the people, the audience, to feel the romanticism with the composers starting from different orders.
Yes. So Dr. Rosa will play Danza del Trigo, which translates Dance of the Wheat. Bellissima. Thank you, Dr. Rosa Antonelli. And that was Danza del Trigo, Dance of the Wheat by Alberto Ginastera. And it's a live performance right from her home to my home to all of your homes. And beautiful playing. Thank you, Rosa.
Thank you.
Yeah, and Dr. Rosa is doing a live YouTube performance on Thursday, June 25th at 7:30 p.m. right from her home to all of yours. So please look for her and go to her website as well. It's rosaantonelli.com and you can find out all about her. Her biography is so long, it would fill up the whole hour just to read it to you. But you can find out so much more about her. And this is from, she's playing pieces from her CD Bridges. And it's a beautiful CD, and all of the music from Latin America, and also Chopin. Maybe Rosa, really quickly, can you explain why you call it Bridges from Chopin to Piazzolla? What is the connection for those who may not know?
Oh, you know, this is a very important question, because it's called Bridges because the idea is Bridges means connections.
Yes.
And this is the connection between five composers through five generations in a relationship of a mentor student. Mm-hmm. And then all the composers, they were traveling to follow their dreams. And all of them, they were literally and musically immigrants. And the underline of the CD is the freedom of communication and bringing the world together.
Yes.
And I forgot to say that Ginastera was a student of Williams. Mm-hmm. I will explain each composer who was a teacher, no?
Yes. Yeah, that's a helpful and educational for all of us to see the connection between all of these composers. So that's really wonderful. I never knew that most of these composers were connected with each other. So beautiful. And Rosa is doing a live performance for us here on the Catholic Channel, SiriusXM 129, Sounds from the Spires. And her next piece is going to be Romance Sans Paroles, Romance Without Words. That's Opus 18, number 4. And this is by George Mathias.
Thank you.
And that was Dr. Rosa Antonelli, who is our guest today, playing a live performance, and that was George Mathias, Romance Sans Paroles, Romance Without Words, Opus 18, number 4, right from her home to all of your homes. And we'll be right back in a couple of minutes to continue talking to Dr. Rosa and listening to her beautiful playing live from her home. And you're listening to Sounds from the Spires on Catholic Channel SiriusXM 129. Brava. That was a Balada para un Loco, which is a tango by Astor Piazzolla. And she reminded me, Dr. Rosa reminded me that of all the pieces on her Bridges CD, that's my favorite.
I know. That's
very romantic.
That's why I'm playing it. And also, you felt it. And I think the audience could feel how it's so romantic. You know, he was from the 20th century, which I forgot to say, from Chopin in the 19th century to Piazzolla in the 20th century, no?
Yes.
A big difference. And
beautiful playing, wonderful. And again, that was a live performance from Dr. Rosa's living room to all of your homes or your cars, wherever you're listening, a live performance by Dr. Rosa, who's a world-renowned pianist. She's a Steinway artist. She's performed all over the world. If you read her biography, she's played in all the major concert halls, especially Carnegie Hall right here in New York, of course. And Dr. Rosa, tell us the relationship between Piazzolla and some of the other composers. You mentioned that this is Bridges, your CD, and how they were all interrelated because of the generational continuity between the student mm-hmm. and the teacher.
Yes. For example, the piece I performed before, the Matallas, first of all, it's a world premiere piece, no? But second, I want to say Matallas was a student of Chopin, who studied with Chopin for many, 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 many years. And after, when I performed Piazzolla, Piazzolla was a student of Ginastera. Uh-huh. Then actually the CD has two very important two evolutions, which one is the one that comes from Chopin to Piazzolla through the five generations, uh-huh. and the other evolution is the one that comes from Williams, who went from Argentina to study with Matallas and brought all the romanticism to the Argentinian culture, and then he mixed it with through Ginastera and Piazzolla, taking different parts of the folklore from Argentina, no? That's why, but you see you feel the romanticism all over.
Of course, yes. It's beautiful playing by our guest, Dr. Rosa, a Steinway artist and world traveler, concertizes all over the world. It's a beautiful piano you have here, and you have all these beautiful plants and flowers all around. What is your piano that you play? What is the brand?
The brand is Steinway from Hamburg.
Oh, Hamburg.
From Alemania. Yes. It's an old piano, but I did all the reconstruction and everything, and this is my favorite. It's the piano that my mother gave it to me.
Oh.
That's why it has a special meaning, a special feelings for me.
Sure. Was she a pianist as well?
You know, she was an opera singer.
Oh, okay.
Yes, in Italy. Yes.
Yes, and so I've heard your story, of course, because I've known you for so many years now. Rosa's family immigrated from Italy, as many Italians immigrated to Argentina. And so you have many Argentinians with Italian last names, such as yours. And beautiful culture that has melded together as a result of the immigration between Italy and Argentina, and you're playing as a result of that.
Piazzolla, his family was from Italy also.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, Chopin was kind of like the grandfather of all of these wonderful pianists that are on your recording. Tell us a little bit about the Nocturne. Why did you choose this? He has so much repertoire. And of course, the Nocturne is beautiful. Why did you choose this one?
Well, this Nocturne has a special, special place in the CD. It's the first piece by Chopin. Because when I performed in one of my concerts, the last concert at Carnegie Hall, when I performed this piece as an encore, not only the president of Albany Records, who was in the audience, but the audience and myself, they said, Rosa, you play a whole program of Spanish and Latin American composers, but when you play as an encore, this Chopin, we felt like it's all romantic. And then I keep that in my head, in my heart, and that remind me to go to the history. And then I realize again that there is a line, direct line, from Chopin to Piazzolla. And plus, this was the first piece by Chopin that my mother brought in a disc. Uh-huh. With all rarities by Chopin, and this was my favorite.
Mm-hmm. It's
very, very, very special for me.
It's very beautiful. People may know it. I believe it was on the movie The Pianist. Have you seen that?
Yes.
Movie?
Yes. Yes.
It's a moving piece whenever I hear it, and of course when you play it as well, Rosa. So now we're going to hear Rosa playing the Chopin Nocturne number 20 in C sharp minor.
Thank you.
beautifully played by Rosa Antonelli. That's the Nocturne number 20 in C sharp minor by Frédéric Chopin. Of course, a beloved piece that is well known by most pianists, of course, but by Polish folks who love his repertoire and beautifully played. And it's a connection. He's like the grandfather of all of the other composers and pianists on your recording. Bridges, beautifully played. Congratulations, Rosa. It's a live performance again from her living room to all of ours. And you can get the recording, Bridges, the bridging from Chopin to Piazzolla, on the Albany label. So Dr. Rosa Antonelli. And she is also playing a live performance from her home on YouTube on Thursday, June 25th at 7:30 p.m. And she'll be playing. Are you playing all of the pieces on your recording, Rosa, or maybe a selection?
A selection, because in internet, if you play like more than 1.5 hours, it's too difficult, no, because of the connection. I will do a selection just to for the audience to have the feeling of the romanticism, and also I wanted to say it's very easy because if they go to youtube.com/c/ Rosa Antonelli, and then that is my channel, and then they see where that says live, live, and they just press there, and they are with me.
That's wonderful.
That is it's magical, no?
Yes, but it's the way to be these days, because most people's concerts have been canceled, maybe with the exception of a few. Your concerts, my concerts, everybody's concerts, and everybody's performing from home or from some location where they're separated from an audience. So it's beautiful that you're able to do this and share your talents even during this time of the pandemic. So congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Yes, yes. And we'll be back in a couple of minutes to continue talking to Rosa and listening to her beautiful performances from her Bridges CD. And you're listening to Sounds from the Spires on the Catholic Channel on SiriusXM 129.
Thank you.
And that was Valse, or Waltz, Opus 29, number 3, and Huella, Opus 46, number 1, by Alberto Williams, performed live from her living room, Dr. Rosa Antonelli, from her home to your home by Zoom. And that is available also on the Bridges CD, that you can get on the Albany label. And also Dr. Rosa is going to give a live performance from her home on Thursday, June 25th at 7:30 p.m. on YouTube. Brava, Rosa.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
What does Huella translate?
Oh, you know, Huella is in Argentina, is huella. Mm-hmm. It means the print that the horses leave on the ground.
Okay.
When they run. It's like a print.
That's right.
It's the print they leave. The typical from the gaucho.
Yes.
No?
Uh-huh.
That's why the rhythm of this piece is like from the horses, no? And then that's why Williams, the waltz is more like, takes the more the romanticism, and the Huella takes more the folklore from Argentina. But the last part you saw, it was like Rachmaninoff. The last
yes.
part, did you hear?
Yes.
It's like a Chopin ballad, the last arpeggios. No?
Yes. And again, you played Chopin right before the break, and so you mentioned that it's like Chopin at the end of the Williams. And all of these composers are interconnected, and hence the title Bridges of your CD. There were so many runs and fast notes in those pieces. How many hours do you practice a day, Rosa?
4 or 5.
Wow.
Yes. I had to keep my back on shape.
Yes.
I love it. This is like, it's like healing to me. It's like it gives me peace.
Yes.
When I don't practice one day, I feel something is missing.
Yes.
Something is not right for me.
It's your love. Okay. And you're going to play another Piazzolla piece. This is Oblivion, a slow tango. And again, on her CD Bridges, which you can get on the Albany label. And also go to Rosa's website, rosaantonelli.com. She'll be giving a live performance on June 25. That's a Thursday at 7:30 on YouTube. But now she'll play for us Oblivion by Astor Piazzolla.
Thank you.
And that was Oblivion, a slow tango by Astor Piazzolla, beautifully played by Dr. Rosa Antonelli. And this is from her living room to all of our homes and our cars or wherever we're listening to Sounds from the Spires on the Catholic Channel. Beautiful performance. And she's also going to repeat these pieces and maybe add some more on Thursday, June 25th at 7:30 p.m. on YouTube Live. So she'll give a full concert without my commentary. And it'll be a beautiful recital from her living room. And Dr. Rosa, we mentioned earlier in the show that there's a large connection between immigrants from Italy to Argentina or vice versa. Or vice versa in the case of our Holy Father. How did you all feel, in a nutshell, how did you all feel when Pope Francis became the Pope from Argentina?
Oh, that was something absolutely touching for me because he's an Argentinian with Italian ancestors. And the funny thing is that Pope Francis, when I studied philosophy and history of arts, and when I was a student of philosophy, he used to give some seminars in the university. Uh-huh. And then I had him in that time, I could see how he was helping people by nature, and I never imagined he could be where he is. Now, it was very special to me, very, very special. I remember I did the concert in the Catholic radio in his honor.
That's right.
Yes, live.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And must be the pride of Argentina.
Yes. Was
very proud. And do you know when your next concert is going to be? I mean, I know that this time is very difficult and people's concerts have been postponed. Besides your YouTube next week, do you have any upcoming performances that you might be able to do?
I had three planned, and then they said that once all of this is over, they will be again with a new date. No, they were in March, April for Harvard, Gold, for many places, and I'm waiting for rescheduling. No.
Yes. It's
It will be in my website.
Okay. Go to Rosa's website, rosaantonelli.com. You can find out so much about her everywhere she's played. She has this long biography of all the concerts she's played, the famous concert halls, and upcoming concerts. You can keep in touch with her there. Or maybe you're listening from a church or a concert hall where you might want to engage Rosa in the future once the pandemic has kind of subsided and people are safe to travel. Rosa will travel anywhere in the world, literally. She's played all over the world. She's world famous, and she will come to you when the time is right and we're all safe. So you can contact her on rosaantonelli.com, as well as find out about her CD Bridges. And her YouTube concert will be Thursday. That's next week, or this week, depending on when you're listening.
Yeah, next Thursday, yeah.
Yes, June 25th at 7:30 p.m. So stay tuned for that. She's a great Steinway artist. And any closing words, Rosa, real quick before we have to end and you play your final piece, Danza Final? Do you have any final words of wisdom?
As always, it's a pleasure to be with you in your program. I thank you very much for this opportunity to present my CD from my home to your home, to other people. I appreciate it. And I hope that this CD for you carries the message of that we are all together, and the music is the one who brings us together.
That's right.
We don't have bridges, we don't have borders, we just are together with the music. I hope to contribute a little bit.
That's a great message, the bridges, the connection, and bringing people together when people are so torn apart right now. We need these bridges, like Rosa said, and the music. Music is a universal language, and it's the one thing that can bring everybody together. You know, when we have countries that are fighting with each other, the musicians always seem to be the ones that are always in harmony with each other. We don't care where we're from. We play with each other. We perform, and we just perform what is beautiful so that all cultures can appreciate.
And you just don't need words. You just listen and that's it.
Exactly. Sans paroles. Yes. So get Rosa CD, Bridges from Chopin to Piazzolla. She's given us a great connection between all of these five composers today, Chopin, Matthias, Williams, Ginastera, and Piazzolla. It's on the Albany label, Bridges. And also go to her website, rosaantonelli.com. And then again, go to YouTube. Tell us that site again, Rosa, YouTube.
Oh, it's youtube.com/C/Rosa Antonelli. Also, if they go to my website, we posted the flyer. Yes. And people just click in the link, mm-hmm. and go there. They don't need to type it. They click on the link and they go directly to YouTube. They click live and we are together. Magic.
Wherever you are in the world, you can watch Rosa. You can be right here in New York with us, or you can be on the side of the planet. Yes. Rosa is going to complete the show today by playing Malambo, the danza final. What is Malambo? What's the translation?
Malambo comes from a dance, one of the most popular dances in Argentina, mm-hmm. that the gauchos is so difficult. It's like aerobic. It's so difficult that there are many competitions about who dance the Malambo better. No, it's practically all in the air. You don't even touch the floor. Mm-hmm. And it's very, 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 very difficult dance, and dance by the gauchos in Argentina.
Beautiful. So Rosa's going to play that for us, the danza final of Malambo of Alberto Ginastera from her own country, Argentina. Rosa, thank you so much for playing for us. It was a pleasure here in our family, here in our living room, to be able to hear you, and then now you're sharing it with everybody. So thank you so much for bringing us Bridges and peace and beautiful music during this time when everybody needs it. God bless you. And thank you to Rosa, thank you to Robert, and we're going to finish out by her live performance in her living room of Danza Final, Malambo by Alberto Ginastera. And stay tuned next week for Sounds from the Spires on the Catholic Channel on SiriusXM 129.
Thank you, Jennifer. Thank you.